Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will learn about how to find total resistance value when number of resistors connected either in series or in parallel combination. Resistors are said to be connected in series when they are connected one after the other, means connected in end to end in a single line. Resistors are said to be connected in parallel when both of their terminals are respectively connected to each terminal of the other resistors. By finding equivalent resistance value, whether resistors connected in parallel or series, we can simplify or solve complex circuit problems. Let us observe what happens when few resistors with different values connected in series with one voltage source. Here, the current flowing through the circuit has no other way. It must pass through the resistors one after the other. For example, like water flow from filled tank to empty container. Here we can consider the water flow from thin pipes as current flow from series resistors. So in series combination of resistors, the current that flows through one resistor must also flow through the others, as it can only take one path. Hence the current is same. If it is 2 amperes when measured at the input, it will be 2 amperes current at any point or even at the output, which means the current at all points is 2 amperes only. So we can say that current through the network I equals to I1, I2 and I3, where I is the current at input, I1, I2 and I3 are currents through the series resistors R1, R2 and R3 respectively. Because of the same current flows through the entire circuit, voltage across each resistor varies according to their resistance values. As the voltage is directly proportional to resistance, the higher the resistance value, the higher is the voltage drop across it. The series resistor network can also be called as voltage divider network. So let's say voltage drops across these series resistors R1, R2 and R3 as V1, V2 and V3 respectively. Here we can apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. The algebraic sum of the voltages around any closed loop is equal to 0. That means Vs minus V1 minus V2 minus V3 equals to 0. We can rewrite it as Vs equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Here, according to Ohm's law, we can write this Vs as I into R, V1 as I into R1, V2 as I into R2 and V3 as I into R3. Now we will substitute these values in the first equation. So the equation becomes IR equals to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Here I is common. Therefore IR equals to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. Dividing both sides by I, we get the value of R equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Hence, if two or more resistors connected in series, the overall resistance R equals to the sum of individual resistances. If three resistors, 1 kilo ohm, 2 kilo ohm and 3 kilo ohm are connected in series, the overall resistance equals to sum of these three resistances, that is 6 kilo ohm. From this, we can understand that if we connect resistors in series, the overall resistance increases. As the current is inversely proportional to resistance, the current will decrease. The current will be same at every point in the circuit. Applied voltage Vs equals to sum of all the voltage drops. The main disadvantage of series circuit is if one component breaks down, the entire circuit will be cut off from the supply. Now let's see what happens when few resistors are connected in parallel. Here we have connected three resistors R1, R2 and R3 in parallel combination, and 10 volts voltage applied across them. If you observe this circuit closely, all the three resistors have connected between two common lines. Let's say them X and Y. And these two lines X and Y are directly connected to voltage source of 10 volts. Hence the voltage drop across each resistor will also 10 volts. So in parallel combination, voltage drop across each resistor will be equal. Now let's see how current flows in the circuit. Here the flow of current can take three paths. So the current will be divided into three parts. Let's say currents I1, I2 and I3 are passing through resistors R1, R2 and R3 respectively. For example, like water flow from filled tank to empty container. If three pipes are connected one above the other between them, the water will flow through all the three pipes. But the rate of water flow will be different. So in parallel combination of resistors, the current can take multiple paths. The flow of current can be branched out at the common starting point, let's say X, and recombines when the branches meet at the common ending point, let's say Y. Since there are multiple paths for the flow of current, the current may not be same through all branches. It depends upon the amount of resistance in that branch. According to Ohm's law, the flow of current is inversely proportional to the resistance. So the higher the resistance of a branch, the lower the current flows through that branch. Here R1 resistor have lowest resistance value of 10 ohms. Hence the current flowing through R1 is higher than the other branches, where the total source current I equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So the parallel circuits are also classed as current dividers. Here we can apply Kirchhoff's current law. The total current entering into a junction is exactly equal to the total current leaving the same junction. I equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3. According to Ohm's law, we can write I as V by R, I1 as V by R1, I2 as V by R2 and I3 as V by R3. Now we will substitute these values in the first equation. So the equation becomes V by R equals to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. Here V is common. So we can write V by R equals to V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Dividing both sides by V, we get the value of 1 by R equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So in parallel combination, the total resistance value can be given by this expression. Hence, when n number of resistors are connected in parallel, the equivalent resistance value can be the reciprocal of the total resistance is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of individual resistances. Hence, the total resistance of the circuit is always less than the smallest resistance value in the circuit. Resistance decreases in parallel combination. The main advantage of parallel circuits are we can connect or disconnect any component in the circuit without affecting the function of the other components in the circuit because each has its own independent connection. Let's solve one example based on the series and parallel combination of the resistors. So here in this circuit, we need to find out the total resistance and the current flowing in the circuit. To solve this type of problems, just start at the back end of the circuit and simplify towards the starting two terminals. If you observe this circuit at the back end, these three resistors are connected in series. So we can replace these three resistors with an equivalent resistor. Hence, the equivalent resistor for series combination Rs equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. That equals to 2 ohms plus 6 ohms plus 2 ohms. That equals to 10 ohms. So, these three resistors can be replaced with one 10 ohm resistor. Now, the circuit looks like this. Here, these two 10 ohm resistors are connected in parallel. So, we can replace these two resistors with one equivalent resistor. The equivalent resistor for parallel combination is 1 by Rp equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. That equals to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10, which gives the value of 2 by 10. Just simplify this, that equals to 1 by 5. Therefore, Rp equals to 5 ohms. So, these two parallel resistors can be replaced with one 5 ohm resistor. Now, the circuit looks like this. That is just three resistors connected in a series combination. So, the total resistance of the circuit Rs equals to 4 ohms plus 5 ohms plus 1 ohm. That equals to 10 ohm. Now, the circuit have a 10 ohm equivalent resistor which is connected to the 10 volt voltage source. According to Ohm's law, current I equals to V by R. That is nothing but 10 by 10. That gives 1 ampere current flowing through this circuit. This is how we can solve complex resistor circuits by simplifying from the back end of the circuit. We will solve such examples in upcoming videos. Here I have summarized the differences between series and parallel combination of resistor network circuits. These can also be applied to any series and parallel combination circuits made up of lamps, batteries and etc. That's all about series and parallel combination of resistor circuits. I hope in this video you have understand how to find the equivalent resistance value when number of resistors connected either in series or in parallel combination. If you learn from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. In my next video, we will discuss about capacitors and how they work. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.